Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for waiting. We have concluded the four-party meeting this morning, and I would now like the IOC President to address you. President.
Thank you very much. It is with great pleasure that I can announce the outcomes of our meeting today. Before I get into this, I would like to thank all the participants for a meeting which was held in the true Olympic spirit of respect and friendship. In particular, my thanks go to the leaders of the delegations who are here with me. The President of the NOC of ROK, Lee Kei-yung, the Minister of Sport of ROK, Do Yong-won, the President of the NOC of DPRK and Minister of Sport, Kim Il-guk, and the President of BOKOK, Lee Hee-bom. Thank you to my fellow IOC Executive Board members, Gunilla Lindberg and Gianfranco Casper, for their great support and enthusiasm. I would also like to express my sincere thanks to all the delegation members and everybody who was working on and behind the scenes. Today marks a milestone on a long journey. Since 2014, the IOC has addressed the special situation of having the Olympic Winter Games 2018 on the Korean Peninsula. Until today, we met separately with the parties on a bilateral basis to address an often fast-changing political situation in a comprehensive way. Today is therefore a great day because the Olympic spirit has brought all sides together. This was not an easy journey, but thanks to the commitment of everyone here today, I am happy to announce that athletes from the NOC of the DPRK will participate in the Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018. The IOC today has taken exceptional decisions and has allocated additional quota for 22 athletes from the NOC of DPRK who will compete in three sports and five disciplines in Pyeongchang. They will be accompanied by 24 coaches and officials. Following the wish of the two NOCs, the IOC has approved their request to have their delegations marching together as one under the name Korea at the opening ceremony of the Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018. This team will enter the Olympic Stadium under the Korean unification flag. I'm sure that this will be a very emotional moment, not only for all Koreans, but also for the entire world. Coming myself from a formerly divided country, it is a moment that I am also personally looking forward to with great anticipation and great emotion. For the first time in Olympic history, the two Korean teams will unite to compete as one team in a sport. The unified women's ice hockey team will be represented by the Korean unification flag and will compete as Korea, with the anthem being the song Arirang. This team will be a great symbol of the unifying power of Olympic sport. These great results could only be achieved with the enthusiastic cooperation of the Olympic Winter Sports Federations, in particular the International Ski Federation, chaired by our colleague Gianfranco Casper, the International Ice Hockey Federation, and the International Skating Union. Let us not forget that such an agreement would have seemed impossible only a few weeks ago. In this respect, I would like to express my most sincere thanks to the governments of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea and the Republic of Korea for paving the way for these decisions in the Olympic spirit. The Olympic Games are always about building bridges. They never erect walls. The Olympic spirit is about respect, dialogue, and understanding. The Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018 are hopefully opening the door to a brighter future on the Korean Peninsula and inviting the world to join in a celebration of hope. The Olympic athletes can show us the way. They show us how to compete peacefully. They show us how, despite all our differences, it is possible for humankind to live together in peace, respect, and harmony. In this way, the Olympic Games show us what the world could look like if we were all guided by the Olympic spirit of respect and understanding. This is the Olympic message that will go from Pyeongchang to the world. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, President. And now we will move to signatures, but first we'll have a photograph here with the five parties here. Thank you very much, gentlemen. And now we will move to signatures. This is a replica of Pierre de Coubertin's original desk. And I will ask the five to sign. And I will also invite our two executive board members, Gunilla Lindberg and Gianfranco Casper, to the stage to sign as well. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Excuse me, President Lee. Thank you very much, President Lee. We'd now like to take one more photo of the group. If we could move the table. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. That concludes today's ceremony, and we look forward to seeing you in Pyeongchang for the Olympic Winter Games 2018.